Telemark skiing. Well, that's a kind of downhill skiing, except you do it with equipment that doesn't allow you to lock the heel of your ski boot onto the deck of the ski. People say it has something to do with it being more graceful or soulful than regular skiing. And I kind of agree, don't you? I mean, this is some graceful shit right here. So this story is about a Telemark skier who's now just a skier. It's been a very long and difficult road. You know, I've had my share of face shots on powder days and face plants on sastrugi. It's been pretty emotional at times, that's for sure. But I've finally reached the point where I can honestly say I feel okay about locking down my heel. You know, but it wasn't always this way. Man, life was pretty good, I tell you. Pretty much every weekend, head up and do some free heel skiing. You know, free your heel, free your mind, and all that shit. You guys know what I'm talking about. You're Telemark skiers, too. But I had a big problem that I was just starting to realize. I had a major addiction. Like most of us, it started with the e-commerce. Yeah, I had all the brands. I had all the sweet looking gear. Yep, you know it. So I went out and bought some new hammerheads, which, believe it or not, represent the pinnacle of engineering achievement for Telemark skiing. This Telemark thing had me get a lot of gear. Helmet, pack, a couple of ice axes, one for walking up coolers, one for hitting snowboarders, had a probe pole so I could find my friends, some crampons, knee pads, yeah, that should have been my first clue, beacon so my friends can find me, kitty scoop. I even bought a carabiner, just because I thought it looked cool. Now them kitty scoops, they're not much for moving snow, might as well get a real shovel here. Yeah, baby, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, and it wasn't just about the gear. I developed a serious addiction to a website about Telemark skiing. I used to just hang out at night, drinking beers, checking out people's posts, maybe even making a few posts of my own. Things got worse when I started actually eating goo and going into the back country. The back country is a place where there are no lifts, where you find a lot of Telemark skiers. But I found I really liked the back country, but I found out it's also a dangerous place. So I got a bunch of books. Books on how to ski, books on where to ski, books on how to avoid getting killed when you're out there in the back country. And I even bought a book that tells you how to crawl out of a crevasse if the shit really hits the fan. I started listening to hippie music like Medeski, Martin, and Wood. I mean, how Telemark is that? You know, it got so bad I even bought myself a pair of Birkenstocks, you know, so I could really be free and soulful like the rest of my Telemark brethren. So everything was going really, really good. But then I discovered something that they didn't tell me at Garp Brothers when I bought my piece Stinks. Telemarking's really hard. I mean, even when you think you got it mastered, you just crash again. But telemarking's kind of like golf in that, you know, every once in a while you make one real good shot and you're hooked again. So then you think you're skiing a chute really well, but then you, you know, you get a little off balance. And then maybe you make a poodle turn and you lean too far forward and you hit some ice and the next thing you know there's some crust and oh, you're down. Yeah, it's that breakable crust stuff, I'm telling you. It'll get you every time. Oh, yeah, that hurts. Breakable crust. It's not meant for Telemark. Stuff will make Donald Rumsfeld cry. Of course, there's always some patchouli-smelling dreadlock telly dude who will tell you that, you know, because of its fore-aft stability and balance and control and all that other crap, that telemarking's actually better for skiing breakable crust. You think I'm thinking that right now? Alright, I'll admit, I'm probably exaggerating. I mean, the whole world isn't made out of breakable crust, is it? And telemarking can be pretty damn fun. So I started doing a lot of telemarking, started doing it a lot in the backcountry, and got kind of good at it. I mean, I wasn't awesome. Bones wasn't bringing up my phone to have me skiing the next unparalleled, but I got good enough that I started climbing up couloirs with my friends and crossing bergschrunds. I learned that a bergschrund is a German crevasse, so it's especially nasty. But what sucks is at the top of these couloirs, you can't click into your binding, and instead you gotta fiddle with it and bend over, and you might lose your patience. Fuck! I mean, there's gotta be a better way, right? But we were pretty tough. We didn't let the equipment get us down too much. We'd still go up and ski the big couloirs. But even then, no matter how good we got...
Oh!
We still had some heinous face plants.
Nice! Look at
Oh!
You right? You look good, though.
So I started asking seriously, is there a better way?